let's move on to some examples. So in this so in this scenario, if Madam Lee, there's a senior Madam Lee, if Madam Lee, a senior that I meet, does not use walking stick, generally can move around independently, but in recent times, she has not been able to do her regular activities. So what do you think are some of the questions that you need to check in with her, you know, like to ask her to find out about her CFS? Yeah, Mahani, you have something you want to.
Why is she unable to do her
activities? Okay, so why is she unable to do her activities? Yeah, like you ask a senior, oh, auntie, why, Madam Lee, why have you not been able to do your activities? What other things can you ask?
Is there anyone to help you with your activities?
Sorry?
Is there anyone to help you with your
activities? Okay, is there anyone to help you with activities? Yeah, thank you, Esther. So, some of the things you can ask is, like what Mahani shared, like, oh, do you actually feel tired or weak more easily compared to now? And another thing that you can actually ask would be, are your medical conditions, if anything, under control? And I think what Esther asked is actually very valid as well, you know, to ask if there's anyone to help you, because if they need help with anything, that will move them from a CFS 3 to a CFS, to a CFS 4 to a CFS 5, you know. So next week, so if actually Madam Lee says that she feels weak and tired more easily, and then you actually circle CFS 4. So next we move on to the, so this is actually an example of CFS 4. So as you can see, so the symptoms limit the activities, it will actually be CFS 4. So next we have another case example. This time it's Madam Tan. So you go into the house, you see, Madam Tan uses a walking stick around the house, but she's not able to do any housework or leave the house or take transport because her knees are too weak to walk, even with the use of a walking stick. Okay, so now you all can take a look at your booklet, right? There's actually, go to page 45. You can actually see that there are some examples, you know, 45 to 47. So you can actually see to guess like which CFS would Madam Tan actually belongs to. So how about this table? Do you have any idea on which CFS you will guess? How about
CFS 5?
CFS 5, okay. What makes you think that it's CFS 5?
Because she's not able to do housework and take transport.
Okay, because she's not able to do housework, right? And take transport. Okay, so that will fall under the CFS 5. How about the table?
Sounds like a 5.
Sounds like a 5 as well. Okay. How about this table over there? How about for this? Do you have?
I think number 6.
What makes you think number 6? And we heard 5, 5, and then we hear number 6.
Because you said that her knee is too weak to walk even with the help of a stick, so she
won't
need someone to help.
Okay, so you know the difference, if you all recall, right, the difference between a 5 and a 6 is that the person actually needs help. Not only needs help in IADLs, but also needs help in BADLs. So like what Felice mentioned, actually one part of walking, you know, as you can recall, in BADL, one of the activities is actually mobility. So in terms of walking, you might want to clarify with the senior further. Oh, what do you mean by your knees are too weak to walk? When you go out, do you actually need someone to accompany you? So let's say, Madam Tan said, yeah, actually I don't need. So that will actually bring her to a CFS 5. So you actually circle CFS 5, even though she's actually using the walking aid. Reason being, she actually needs help with one of her IADLs. So, here you can see. So because she actually needs help with one of her IADLs, and don't need help in any BADLs, it's actually a CFS 5. Okay, next example. So there was this senior Mr. Goh. So Mr. Goh was actually sitting on the couch when you visit. So during the conversation, you know, you talk to Mr. Goh. Oh, Mr. Goh, how are you? What can you, like, ask him about his HFS? And he actually shared, oh, he's actually not able to shower himself. And then he needs his family members to help him transfer from his bed to his chair. So what CFS would that be?
6.
6, okay. So that will fall under CFS 6, right? Seems like you are getting more and more experience because I can hear the response getting faster from you guys. So this is correct. This is actually a CFS 6. Reason being, he needs help in one of his BADLs. So as you can see, now it's actually he's actually falls under CFS 6 because he actually needs help in his BADLs. And why is he actually not a CFS 7? It's because although he needs help in his BADRs, he's actually not completely dependent. So this means that you also need to check with Mr. Goh to see what are actually some of the BADRs that he needs help with, you know, so that you can determine whether is it a 6 or 7. But here I also like to assure you, although there's a need to be accurate about it, but it's not say it's die that you must, oh, you know, if I really need to clarify if really it's a 6 or it's a 7, or you know, like, you can always put it in your case notes, and then your DL to actually be able to help you as well. Because I know that being new, you might be worried, hey, what if I get this wrong, you know, what are the repercussions, do I have to go back and ask again, you know. So you don't need to worry too much, but do indicate in your case notes. Okay, so yeah, we come to the end of my part. Thank you.